Kololo Senior Secondary School is one of the most treasured secondary schools in Kampala. The school celebrated its 69th anniversary this year. Although it's almost 70 years old, the school is well maintained, especially its compound and appearance, which is based on conserving the environment, including well-kept trees, grass, and flowers around the school. Not only that, the students, with the help of their teachers, have invented various things to teach their fellow students to be environmentally friendly. They use dry bottles to make fences to prevent students from stepping into grass and unauthorized areas. The bottles are painted in attractive colors. They also use the same bottles to make garbage collection bins that they distribute around the school to prevent littering, and also planted environmentally friendly signs in the school. Also, students at the school collect otherwise hazardous plastic bags and wrap them in balls used for football and boxing at the school, and then make decorating items from the papers they collect around the school. In a bid to save the wood they use for cooking, which is mainly from cutting trees, they are currently building a biogas project. They hope that if finished, it will really help them. They are also making charcoal from waste, which they use to save the wood. In classes, teachers set various lessons on climate change and how to mitigate it using the weekly New Vision environmental leaflets distributed to them by teacher Rachel Akol, who is also the Green Schools Project Coordinator. Akol has explained the initiative and thanked Vision Group and its partners for the theme.
We are really doing a lot because the person who thought about getting the learners on board was actually good enough, because most of the messages, as if you want the messages actually to go to our communities, the learners are the best messengers. Yes, so with the climate change, since we actually brought it to them, we've been having actually all those innovations. But again, we are going to improve them more, because now New Vision is coming in to see to it that we are supported. So as a teacher, I'm seeing that these learners are really so interested. Because of the activities that we have actually so far given them, they are the ones that have made them.
The students shared what they learned through the initiative and promised to take it forward.
We've been able to transform these waste, for example, making the paper and other waste in the environment, to make them into briquettes. And these briquettes can be used to substitute charcoal, which charcoal is good from cutting down trees. And this, when these trees are cut down, it causes climate change.
We have been doing so many things that are destroying the environment, the beauty of the environment, such as putting up industries, most especially in a congested place. So these factories release a lot of carbon into the atmosphere, that when it destroys the ozone layer, we receive that much heat from the sun that hits us hard, and that is why most of us, we're feeling so hot some days behind, some weeks behind, I mean. So we felt that heat for quite good time, because we had destroyed the ozone layer.
I would love to urge students, first of all, to avoid dumping and littering the environment with things like polythene bags, things like bottles, which actually destroy the environment.
According to the principal of Kololo Senior Secondary School, Edward Kanonya, environmental protection is one of their priorities. He thanked New Vision for the initiative.
We have a population of over 4,000 learners who go home every day. So when they carry information, now it reaches to, if you multiply, if every home has about four people or three, so the multiplier effect is really sizable. So the intervention by New Vision and its partners to target schools in terms of environment issues and climate change in particular, I think was a timely intervention, which is aimed at ensuring that there is tomorrow. We need to use the environment, well aware that there is tomorrow and that the world is not ending today.
Report compiled by Adrian Baliwanika for the news.